Now we're gonna flip her facing towards the ventilator. One, two, three, flip, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay.
The intensive care team at Tallaght Hospital in Dublin proning a patient during this latest wave of COVID-19. It's now a familiar treatment here and in the ICUs across the country for patients whose lungs aren't functioning. Since Christmas Eve, the number of people in ICU has increased almost tenfold. Nearly a month into level 5 restrictions, it had been anticipated that pressure on hospitals would ease this week.
That hasn't happened. We haven't seen that yet. The numbers in the ICUs, they continue to go up slowly, but they continue to go up. And that remains worrying and remains the current pattern, the current trend.
Hospitals are now in surge capacity because ICUs are full, and redeployed staff are pairing up with trained ICU nurses to look after the sickest patients.
What stands out is the sheer numbers in with one particular condition, COVID-19. And while there are 200 in the ICUs, there's about 300 requiring high amounts of oxygen, what we call non-invasive ventilation, throughout the wards in our hospitals in the country being cared for also.
Hospitals in Galway were under significant pressure today, compounded by staff being absent.
We have over 400 people currently on COVID-related leave between the two hospitals, and it's extremely difficult to provide full and safe services with that number of people away.
Last April, there was capability to look after 350 patients in permanent and temporary critical care beds. Today, just 8 of those beds are free. And according to the HSE's clinical lead for critical care, beyond that, the care becomes unreliable. Sharon Tobin, RTE News.